Making a YouTube banner can be hard. You need to make sure the banner is custom and suits your brand. It also has to fit across a variety of different devices, and graphic design programs can be very expensive. But today, I'm going to be teaching you how to make your own YouTube banner. A banner that's custom to your brand, fits across every single device, and helps you convey your message for absolutely free. So with that being said, let's get started. Now we are going to be making our banner in Canva. Canva is a free tool that is very easy to use, and it also has a lot of elements built into it for free, so you can make your banner very quickly with Canva, and all we're going to do is sign up with email and create an account. Now once you log into Canva, you're going to notice that they have a lot of different templates already available, and if you look up YouTube banner, they actually have a bunch of YouTube channel art templates as well. Now we are going to be making our banner from scratch because we want to make a custom banner for our channel. If you want to use templates, I wouldn't recommend that you use Canva because Canva has very limited amounts of templates. Instead, I would recommend that you use a website such as Placeit because Placeit has a lot more templates you can use. It's a lot easier to edit within their website, and you can also customize your template in a bunch of different ways that Canva would not allow you to do. So we're going to be creating our banner from scratch in Canva, and all you want to do is click on create a design and click on custom dimensions. We're going to make it 2560 by 1440 because that is the size of a banner, and we're going to click on create design. You can click on the top right just to rename your file. And the next step is to go into uploads and upload all of the assets that you're going to need to build your banner. So here you would add your background, any images or pictures that you want to have in your banner, or social media icons, which we're not going to need because Canva has them built in. But basically, uploading all your assets first will make the design process a lot faster because you won't have to constantly download new things or switch tabs. So we're going to do that very quickly. So as you can see, I've uploaded my two assets, and the first one is a background. If you want to find your own background, you can just use Google Images. One tip I do have is that when you're searching for a background in Google Images, make sure you go into the settings, and you go into the advanced settings, and you select image size large, just so it filters all of the images. And you want to make sure your image is 2560 by 1440. If you're curious on what you should Google, I Googled purple gradient background, as you can see here. And you can do this with any other pattern, so I can look up orange grunge background, for example, or if I wanted something more simple, I can look up wood background and a bunch of backgrounds come up. Now we're just going to click on the background and drag it to our canvas. And what you'll notice is that it'll lock into place, and then we're going to let go. We're going to click on this image, and then we're going to click on the lock button just so that we don't accidentally move it. Now the second image we're going to add is this guidance image, which I'll link down below with everything else. And basically what this image allows you to do is it allows you to see what parts of the banner will be visible on different devices. So even though the banner image is very large, you're not going to be able to see the entire banner on a phone. On a phone, you're just going to be able to see this light blue safe area. So we want to be very mindful of this when we're adding elements to our banner. We're just going to click on the opacity button and lower it to about 10% so that we can see this and use it as a guidance. And we're going to be removing it later on. And then we're going to press on the lock button so it's also locked into place. Now I'm just going to do one more thing with the background, and I'm going to add a pattern to it. This is of course optional, but if you want to do this as well, just go into elements where you can see all of the elements you can use and search for pattern, and a bunch of patterns will come up. And I'm a pretty big fan of this pattern over here. So I'm just going to click on it, and it's going to show up on my canvas, and I'm going to enlarge it and make it fit the entire banner. It's not going to lose quality, which is really nice because it's a vector. And then what I can do is I can click on these colors over here and edit the colors of this pattern. So I'm going to click on the blue one and make it white, so it's a white to purple pattern. And then I'm just going to lower the transparency of it to around 5%. And that looks pretty good to me. And that's what I'm going to use for the background. Now the next step is to add some text. So we're going to be adding three elements. We're going to be adding our main title text, a description of our channel, as well as a social media handle. So I'm just going to click on add a heading and just type in the main text, which is the channel name. And I'm going to make it Ziovo. And you can click on the fonts on the top left and choose any font that you like. I'm a big fan of a font called Intro. So I'm just going to click on that font and use it. And it's going to change the font. And then you can also click on the text to move it around. So I'm just going to move it right here. And now we're going to add our header. So underneath this text, the subheading is going to show what our channel is actually about. So we're just going to click on add a subheading, and I'm going to make my subheading YouTube tips and tutorials. And then I'm going to highlight this and of course make it smaller. I think 32 is also too big. Maybe 24. Yeah, 24 is nice because it's as long as the main heading. And then I'm also going to go ahead and make sure it's centered to the middle, which it'll show this icon. And then I'm going to change the font. So I think for the subheading, I'm going to use a different font. And I'm just going to find one that I like. I think Anonymous Pro looks good. So I'm going to just click on it, and it's going to change the subheading as well. And then what I can do is I can just click on it and move it as well, and I can align it with the main text. Now you can also use shapes to make some text stand out. So I think this looks a little bit boring right now because both of these are the same color. So I'm going to add a shape behind my subheading. So all you want to do is go into Elements, and we're going to just close this and go into the shape section and click on see all. And I'm going to use this rounded rectangle. And then what we can do is we can just have it be the right dimension for the subheading. So as you can see, once again, the grid lines will help move it into the right place and align it to the middle of the rectangle and the entire canvas. Then we're going to click on the actual shape, and I'm just going to change the color to black. And then I'm going to change the opacity to around 30%. I think 30% would look nice, and maybe a little bit more, maybe 50%. Okay, we're gonna go in the middle with 40%, and that looks nicer to me. And I'm going to just zoom out really quick by pressing Control minus, and that looks a lot better in my opinion. Now, before we add our social media handles, the next step is to add a few more elements. So you can add a bunch of pictures on the side because there's a lot of space left, or you can add other shapes, and you can use your own images if you have them. You can use Google, but I'm just going to use the elements because there are a lot of elements that you can use. And some things you can look up, for example, are like Scribble. And if I look up Scribble, there's a bunch of cool scribbles that I can add to my banner, and it'll help, you know, take up the space and make it look more complex. So I'm going to use this one because this one looks really nice, and I'm just going to drag it to my banner, and then I'm going to move it so it's over here. And then I'm just going to make it a bright like lavender, and then I'm going to lower the opacity, and I think that looks good. Let me just see how it looks with the white. Yeah, I think the lavender looks better. And then I'm going to just copy this by pressing Control C, and then press Control V to paste it, and also put it on this side. So we have this cool like line pattern going across the entire banner, and I think that looks good for the background. And now what we're going to do is we're going to add our social media handles to this banner as well. Finally, we're going to add our social media handles, and the first thing I'm going to do is just add the text. So I'm going to use the same text as the subheading. So I'm just going to zoom in by pressing Control plus, and I'm going to click on the shape and then shift click on the text so they're both selected. And I'm going to Control C and Control V it to copy and paste it. And I'm going to put this on the side over here like so. And I'm just going to put my Twitter handle. So I'm going to put at Sciovo, which you should go follow if you aren't following it already. And I'm going to make this a bit smaller. I'm going to keep some room over here to actually put the Twitter logo. And then I'm also going to keep this rectangle because I think it looks nice and it goes with the theme of the channel banner. And I'm just going to drag it so that it's smaller as well. And now we just have to add the final Twitter logo. And what's really nice is that you don't have to actually Google it. There's actually elements within Canva that you can use. So if I just Google Twitter, for example, a bunch of free Twitter logos show up that I can use with my banner. And so I'm just going to use this one, the transparent one, and drag it. And then I'm going to resize it and make it a lot smaller. And then I'm just going to add it over here and align it to the middle like so. And I can also change the color of it. So I'm going to make it the same lavender because I think that looks nice. Now our banner is complete. All we have to do is delete the guidelines. So I'm just going to shrink this pattern a little bit so I can select this. I'm going to unlock it, I'm going to press delete, and then I'm going to move the pattern back. And as you can see, our banner is now complete. Now, if you want to download this banner, all you have to click on is the download button and download it as a PNG at the original size, and then click on download, and it's going to download as the file name that you set at the start of the video. Now, to change your banner on your channel, all you have to do is click on the camera icon at the top right, and then select a photo from your computer. And from here, you're going to select the banner that you've downloaded. So mine is over here, and then it's going to upload. And you're going to see that when you click on adjust a crop, you're not going to have to adjust it because we made the banner the exact size it's supposed to be. But we can also click on devices preview to see how it looks on every device. And as you can see, we can still see the Twitter handle on our mobile. So all of the elements we want to be shown will be shown across all the devices. And then all we have to do is press select, and our banner has been uploaded. So that's about it for this video, guys. Hopefully you did enjoy it. If you did, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up. And as always, thanks for watching. My name is Iovo, and I'm signing out.